Johnny Fontana, Half Amazing TV, back with another video.
That cigar is the moment. Then yeah. There's cigars that enhance the moment. The stronger and darker cigar, the more it's like it grabs your attention.
Dominate, yeah.
That being said, sometimes you don't want that. You want to hey, hang out with me. Like how? So not that one's better or worse. It depends what kind of moment. So first, I ask someone how much you want to spend, how much time you want to spend it. That affects the size, right? You know what I'm saying? And what kind of mood you're trying to create? If you're saying I want a real dark, scary, potent mood, okay. Well, you see what I'm saying though? So people don't think about that. They're just like, oh, buy a cigar, how much you got? How much you want to spend? And that's like that's only part
it's about creating a whole experience.
Yeah. Yeah. And guys don't think of it that way.
Yeah.
Today we're gonna do something different, right? 21 is the year of integrity we was talking about before. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to do a subscriber critique, right, of his mix. Fellow who recently emailed me, right? And I started listening to his tech mix and I was like, wow. Like this would be the perfect opportunity for me to examine it, assess it, critique it, right? So that everyone can learn, even myself, right? Because that's how you learn, right? You learn by assessing, figuring out, and then new ideas come to reason, and then you start to understand, okay, why this is. So for example, as I was listening to the mix, I started better understanding, now I know why certain people are having a hard time with certain genres, right? So let's get into it.
When you smoke a cigar, there's no wrong cigar. There is the message. So maybe you have the wrong message. So when they make a cigar, they create a blend or an idea or a concept, what they were going for, what the message is to you. So if you were in some type of mood, you're like, man, I want this. I want a scary cigar that's very cheap. Oh, I want a scary cigar. It's very expensive and luxurious. Well, why are you smoking a Romeo 1875? And that has its place, but do you understand what I'm saying? If you have a cigar that's not what its intended use, and you're like, that wasn't good. No, you're not good. You're not good. You're not a good person. Oh, wow, he's kind of harsh. You need to rethink how you use things, right? There are cigars that are the moment, and cigars that enhance the moment. This cigar is not a moment. This cigar will enhance your moment.
Email from Dan. I'll leave the actual link to the Mixcloud. All right, go ahead and, you know, give him a shout. Look out for him, you know what I'm saying to you. It's only right. It's only proper, right? That's how we do things, right? I wish I had like a more private community base where we can start doing this kind of stuff. If you have any ideas, let me know. Because I want to like have it where it's not a whole lot of folks. I'm not into having a whole lot of folks disrupt, you know what I'm saying, to in the environment and a lot of chaos. I like everything sort of small and able to sort of manage, right? But anyway, he says, hope you and your family are safe and well. Love the new video. So great to see your content from you. Oh, sorry. So great to see new content from you. I was late coming to your channel, but your tutorials have been a huge inspiration. I recorded a couple sets and I'm more than happy to pay for your time, which I don't accept payments for mixed critiques. That's just not something I do. Again, I just give back to the community. But would love to get your feedback on how I can get on the path out of Trash City. So, hey, listen, I asked him, say, yo, dude, you know what? I started listening to it. And I was like, you know what? Let's do it live. So I've actually heard the first two tracks. But I stopped it and I was like, you know what, dude? Let me do it live. And he was okay with it. He sent me the mix. So I think let's go ahead and just go straight into the mix, right? All right. So when I told him, when I emailed him back, I was like, yo. Just listening to this. I'm hyped and I'm like, I hope that you can follow this, right? Because I didn't hear the mix yet. And if not, you better make up for it for like banging tracks. So right off the bat, I'm feeling the energy, because again, after you listen to music a lot of times, you could sort of hear like the first 15 seconds of a track and you can be like, oh, this is gonna be good. Sometimes like the artist doesn't really take it where it needs to be taken, but for the most part, if I hear a track, I can be like, yo, this is gonna be hot. So from this right here, again, I knew it was gonna be something similar to this, and I'm feeling it. Right? So what I'm gonna do, I'm not gonna play the whole like song, because I want people to like start understanding like how things are working. But let me explain to you about tech, progressive tech, this new sort of melodic techno, whatever, that's really progressive tech house, but they call it, you know, techno. It's like progressive tech, but nonetheless, and this is just recently what I've come to realize. I've always understood this, but this is what I've come to better understand in terms of being able to articulate so that you guys can understand. Look at the patterns. No, the pads. All right, this is, I call this progressive tech. A lot of people call this techno. It's not techno. Anyway, the secret to progressive or even tech, with the groovy style, right, of progressive tech, melodic tech, is that you don't have a lot of bandwidth to work with. Let me explain. When it comes to like funky or, you know, other styles, you have a lot of bandwidth, so you can go from up and down. So if you have a funky right style, you can play more like more sort of like a groovy funk, more of like a tech funk, more of like a disco funk, funk with like instruments, guitar, piano, vocally, you know, fast, big room, twisted, filtery. You have so many different, you know, textures that you can work with when it comes to like funky, right? Or even Latin, same thing, right? You have more of the funky Latin, you have the groovy, you have the soul Latin, minimal Latin, techie Latin. But when it comes to like this kind of stuff, you're limited, right? So which means that as you progress, how you transition from one sound to another makes a bigger difference, because it's more apparent, if you understand what I'm saying to you. So if you go from this to another track, you should sort of, at least this is your first track, go something similar, and then from there you can change it, right? So at least two or three tracks, but you don't want to go something drastic. And unfortunately, another track that's tech or progressive can alter the actual trajectory of where you want to go. So let's see. All right, so now he's changing it. So with this right here, you want to keep it going. You can switch the basses, but it has to be something along the lines. Like the bass has to be as subtle. You can't have a tough bass. So let's see what he's going to do here. All right, transition was fine. But here's what people get mixed up. They think, oh, well, the song went, the transition was fine. What's going on here now? What do you think? Let's let it play out a little bit. You see how it's a totally different texture now? Before it was groovy.
There are cigars that are the moment and cigars that enhance the moment. This cigar is not a moment. This cigar will enhance your moment.
So now this is more of like an anthem. This is more of like when you were going and you kept on going it for a minute and then you dropped it down to have. In order to recover, right? To sort of regroup, like you want to change up the sound a little bit, you want to change up the atmosphere. Again, this is a mix, this is not live. So since you're doing it live, I mean, since you're doing a mix, you have all the time to prepare and make sure that all this pairs well and that you paint that picture. You see, now it's more like a fuller. It totally changes, and there's nothing wrong with this song. But he didn't work anything up to this. He should have worked at least 2-3 tracks, at least I would say 3, because this is a totally different song than that one. So, let me find a track really quickly that I think will go with the one before. So I'm gonna have to like stop it because it's just, you know, too much time. All right, so we got that right here, right? Remember that? So here's a track that I would play. Hold on. That's something similar to this, right? May not be the same track, but I mean, I'm gonna give you an example. You see what I'm saying to you? It's got a similar. Similar groove, similar pattern. Again, it took me about, 3 minutes to find it, because I know my music. You see what I'm saying to you? And even if I don't know, I can just go through them and say, okay, what would go with this? But again, I'm not gonna just pick any song. That's the point I'm trying to make to you. Even if I didn't know this song right here. But I'm like, okay, this sounds relatively similar. Even if it's not gonna be perfect, but it sounds together match this more than that. Okay, again, this is a little bit more light. This is a little tougher, right? So I probably wouldn't play this track with it. You know? So I would probably play maybe that one first and then this one second. You know, you see what I'm saying to you? So let's go back to it. So he went from that to this now. Now you started to see what I'm saying, right? And in terms of people, DJs just picking songs just randomly, right? Again, I'm giving Dan a pass here. I'm giving him a pass. Why? Because it's difficult. I'm giving him a pass, and not because he emailed me and then I'm being easy on him. No, I mean, he's still Trash City and he acknowledges that, right? But I'm giving him a pass because they're very similar profiles, right? And unless you really study the music, you're just gonna play this and you think it sounds good. So, and so you started to mix it here. And the problem is that you go from this to another to something else. This is more powerful. Then you go down to that other, it's another texture. There was nothing in between, right? You have to bridge the song. So I have, remember the mix that I did? I'm gonna look for it. Look. This would have been fine. Okay, I would have gone, if I'm gonna go from that, let's say I have a 3-4 and I wanna just basically like change the atmosphere a little bit, I would come to this. This is not a bad thing. But there's a way to do it that captures the audience and situation. You see, now it's over now. You see how it's just, whatever. So let me find my mix and then I'll play it for you so that you can hear what I did. All right, so now I'm gonna change it a little bit. I'm gonna go for like a more, like a darker sound, or slow it down, right? I'm gonna reset it a little bit because now everyone is in, right? Everyone is in, so I'm gonna reset it now, go a little darker, bring down the tempo a little bit, and go a little darker, right? Because we're sort of peak hour now. And I'm gonna reset it. And because I'm gonna change the sound, I'm gonna reset it, I'm gonna allow the track to play out a little bit more. So people can get used to that new sound. I'm gonna stay in this folder and I'm gonna start doing some more breakdown mixing.
say in this folder.
See how I paired that now, all right? Because it's a totally new vibe now. Let's go with this one now. What we got here? The mixing is not bad so far. Okay, I like it. When that beat drops, it better be consistent and not be on some crazy stuff. Think you're looping it. Okay. All right then. Okay. All right. I'm gonna give it very nice. Yeah, the ending. You know, you could have did a distractor, right? Maybe like lower the bass, right? Did an echo and then waited for a nice transition point, right? Because like right now there's no real transition point. So you wanted to wait for like a bigger major one in order for you to let the other one go. But it's fine. But you still kept the groove, which is good. Perfect. I love this track. I don't even know this track, but I love it. Playlist? I like this track. But you see, right? So the whole letting it go thing, that's why for me, I guess my thing, I cannot just let go. Like everything has to be like, you know, with the music. But this is... He kept the groove. That's the main part, main point. That's the other part is just me being like perfection, like a perfectionist, but it's fine though. All right, let's move it up a little bit.
Granted, if you're looking for a long story and you want a Churchill, then that's what you're going for, because all you want to build up. You want to get all the background of the cigar and slowly build up. You see what I'm saying though? Some people might consider that boring. Well, to me, it depends what kind of mood I'm in. If I'm looking for a short moment, get right to the fucking point. Do you see what I'm saying, though? And that's the benefit of those cigars. But if you're looking to relax and willing to hear the full story, not the condensed version, it's like, yeah.
All right, he's moving something in, something else. Again, there's nothing wrong with the mix now and the song, but now you started to understand when I say distractor and to create that bridge, because he just threw it in there. It's not bad, it flows, it's mixing. So which means that Dan is a guy who understands music now, okay? So we just basically have to work with him on fine-tuning the transitions, like the bridging, but as far as keeping the sounds together, he's doing a great job. I think he is, right? All right, let's move it up a little bit more. Sounds like this got something else coming in. Yeah, he's got something else coming in. What is this now? So what do we, this is not top 40 style mixing, right? Quick mixing, in and out and get out. This is what we have right now. Music selection is great, but you just threw everything off, dude. Like, that was trash, right? The music is great. I love this track. It's beautiful. But again, like you messed it up because you messed up the vibe. So people can't appreciate it. You see what I'm saying to you? Like, you can't. Like, but you didn't lead up into it. And not only that, you've gone from this to one before, and it's very choppy now, right? So people are like, but except the people who are just sitting there, they don't really, like, they're all jacked up in the head. Everything is just, you know, but you gotta be an official booth rider, dude. Like, you gotta be able to transition it well, right? And I think right now what you're not doing, you're not extending your songs. You're just going from now, you're just going from like track to track. Let's go down to another one.
Like, if you got only 20 minutes, you can't read all of Shakespeare, but if you get, you know, Shakespeare for Dummies, I get that. You can get an over idea, almost like ESPN. Just give me a 30-second recap, man. And that's what Short Cigar. Short Cigars are like the recap of what the whole original blend would be in a shorter version. But doesn't give you a lot of time. Depends on what you want.
All right, Dan. Now you're in techno now. Again, nothing wrong, but you've become an automated track picker. All right, we're gonna stop it. All right, we're gonna stop it. Cause I really can't take any more, because it's not that the music is bad, it's just I pretty much know where you're going right now. So what have we learned from listening to this, guys, right? We know that he doesn't have longevity. What does that mean? Which means that you're good, you're coming in, and like you know those couple tracks, but then what, like 20 minutes in, you got 40 minutes left, and you've just become a track picker now, right? Like, you're not even doing your transitions properly. But again, this is not something that I expect for you to now know, like, off the bat. Like, that's what you have to understand. Like, I'm not telling you this because I think you are an awful DJ. I'm saying, like, these are just the fine tunings. As far as mixing is concerned, you're mixing fine, right? There's no problem with it. But now, what makes you different, again, than someone else mixing songs? The difference is how you bridge, how you paint that picture, that paint that journey. You went from now all that to a techno, but you didn't lead up to that techno track, right? And not only that, you didn't give any bridge. So I can understand, for example, let's say you were at live somewhere and you needed to get into techno because like, oh, they want techno. All right, fine. You can do that. And then all of a sudden they hear techno. Oh, hey, okay, yeah, yeah. That's different, right? But if you're making a mix at your house, you're doing whatever, you're supposed to take that time to be able to bridge music, paint that picture, extend the sounds, right? Maybe 2, 3, 4 songs and then go to another sound, right? And then you can play around. You can go from like 2, 3 songs and then do like one weird one and then come back down. But the transition, that bridge has to make sense because you have to get people to adjust it to the new sound. You can't just do this top 40 stuff. And that's where the patience comes, right? Patience, just not only patience with the mix, but patience into like, okay, let me provide them that steady adjustment, right? Calm is cool, calm is swift, calm is fast, right? Just let them appreciate the new sounds. Let it unravel, right? Slowly. So again, you did a great job for a minute there. You had a couple songs that, okay, that, you know, sounded correctly, but you have to, you become, again, you didn't have that longevity, only 20 minutes in, and you just become a track picker, trash picker. You know what I'm saying to you, Dan? So, love the music though, right? I love the mixing, but what makes you any different? That's the point that I'm trying to make. You know what I'm saying to you? That's what I'm trying to do. Like, okay, you can mix. You got great song selection. Okay, what makes you any different? Why do I need to pick you over someone else? That's the whole point. So hope everyone else is watching, is listening, right, and watching, because we learn together, right? This is how we learn. This is not something that, you know, we need to be embarrassed about or whatever. Like, no, it's a family, right? And that's why I feel like, you know, this is how we learn. Like, I just came from a class. I was training for 4 weeks. Like, yeah, like, you got the feedback in front of you. Yeah, this is what you did. This is what you didn't do right. This is what you did wrong. You know, this is what you did correctly. And I think it's important to give you that feedback, you know, face to face, you know, instead of hiding and then letting you go and think that you're doing something when you're not really doing it properly. So, anyway, hope you enjoyed it. If you think you like this format, right, send me your mixes and we'll do them. We'll do them like once a week, you know. And it'll help me, right, better understand mixes and how people and start to find patterns, but it also help you guys, right? Because then you can be like, yo, like, I'm doing that, but then someone else is doing it, and now I see what he's saying, like, in terms of just going from one song to another song. Yeah, the great song selection, the great mixing, but now it's become like a top 40 mix where everything is going fast and not having that patience to let the music, you know, really layer, you know, in order to adjust or allow people to adjust to the new sounds. You see what I'm saying to you? So it's just one of those things you just have to really take heed to, right? So anyway, I think that's a bit for now. Johnny Fontana, Half Amazing TV, we out.